Magandang araw po sa inyong lahat. Ako po ang inyong teacher sa math, si Sir Narsing. Sa video ito, i-discuss natin ang operations for set. Gaya ng union of sets, intersection of sets, complement of set, and set difference of sets. Kasama rin sa i-discuss natin ang cardinality of set, Cartesian product, disjoint set, at saka ang equal and equivalent sets. Sa union of sets, ito yung pinagsama ang mga elements ng given sets. Halimbawa, mayroon kayong set A and set B. So, A union B ay, kumbaga, yung elements ni A ay isasama mo sa elements ni B. So, by definition, the X or the elements of this is an element of A union B if and only if X is a member of at least one of A and B. So, ibig sabihin, dapat daw si X, member siya ni A, or member ni B, or parehas member ni A and B. So, ang Venn diagram ng union of sets ay ito. Itong kulay green. So, makikita nyo yung set A, yung first circle, yung left side, tsaka yung set B, yung sa right side na circle, pinagsama. Okay? So, halimbawa, sa example number 1, we have set A. Ang set A may mga elements na 1, 2, 3, and 4. Set B may mga elements naman na 2, 4, and 6. So, ano ang union ni A at saka ni B? So, A union B has an elements of 1, 2, 3, 4, and 6. So, makikita nyo yung 1, 2, 3, 4 elements yan ni A, yung 2, 4, and 6 elements naman ni B. Pero kung titingnan nyo rin ng mabuti, yung 2, makikita natin kay A at saka makikita rin natin kay B. Pero pag sinulat mo siya sa A union B, isang beses mo lang siyang isusulat. Ganun din yung 4, dalawa. May 4 si A, may 4 din si B. So, isusulat mo rin siya ng isang beses sa A union B. Okay po, maliwanag. Second example, si set A may elements na A, B, and C. Set B may elements na 1, 2, and 3. Okay? So, A union B is equal to or has an elements of A, B, C, 1, 2, and 3. So, tingnan nyo, pinagsama lang si A, B, C, tsaka si 1, 2, 3. Kasi yung A, B, C, elements lang na A, no? Elements of A, 1, 2, 3 are elements of set B. Okay? So, intersection of sets or product or meet. The intersections of sets A and B symbolizes by this one and read as A intersection B or A cap B is the set of all objects which are members of both A and B. So, dito naman sa intersection of sets, dapat daw members ni A at saka ni B. Okay? So, ano ang Venn diagram ng intersection of sets? Ito yon. Ito yung kulay green. So, makikita nyo, yung kulay green, member siya ni set A, yung circle na to, at saka at the same time, member siya ni set B. Yan po ang ibig sabihin ng intersection of sets. So, halimbawa, so, set A, meron tayong 1, 2, 3, and 4. Set B, meron tayong 2, 4, and 6. So, ano ang A intersection B? So, titingnan mo dito sa A kung ano yung elements na makikita mo rin kay B. So, 1, merong 1 si A, wala si B. May 2 si A, may 2 rin si B. So, isusulat mo ang 2. May 3 si A, walang 3 si B. May 4 si A, may 4 si B. So, isusulat mo dito yung 4. May 6 si B, wala naman si A. So, therefore, A intersection B has an elements of 2 and 4. Ito yung elements na makikita mo sa set A at set B. Okay? Example number 2. Set A has an elements of A, B, and C. Set B has an elements of 1, 2, and 3. So, ano kayang elements natin dito sa intersection? Kung susuriin mo, wala. Walang intersection. Walang common. members or walang common elements yung set A and set B. So, ang answer natin dyan ay empty. Itong symbol na open and close braces. Wala kang ilalagay sa loob, blanco siya. Or, itong symbol na empty. Okay, let's proceed to the complement of set. The complement of set, let A be subset of universal set U. The complement of set A, written as A bar or A prime, and read as the complement of A, is the set of all elements of universal set that are not A in A. Okay po. So, ang Venn diagram po niya ay ito. Itong white area, ito po yung set A. Yung shaded area na green, iyan ang complement of set A. Okay? So, halimbawa, number one, the universal set has an elements of the first 10 integers or integers from 1 to 10. Then, set B has an elements of 1 to 6. Okay? So, ano po yung complement of set A? So, yung complement of set A po, ay ito po yung mga members na hindi mo makikita kay A, kay set A, pero makikita mo sa universal set. So, in this example, the complement of set A has the complement of set A has an elements of 7, 8, 9, and 10. Okay, so next example. So, the given are universal sets such that has an elements of X such that X is the set of Filipino alphabet. Okay. Set A has an elements of X such that X is the set of vowels in Filipino alphabet. So, ano yung complement ni set A? So, the complement of set A is the set of all X such that X is the set of consonant Filipino in Filipino alphabet. Okay? So, set difference of sets. Let A and B be subsets of universal set U. The set difference of A and B are relative complement of B with respect to A, written as A minus B, or the complement of B with respect to A is the set of all members in A that are not in B. So, kumbaga, yung A minus B mo, yung assuming na yung X is the elements of universal set such that X is the element of A, pero yung X naman ay hindi naman element ni B. Okay? So, para mas klarado, ito po yung kanyang Venn diagram. So, yung shaded part, ito yung A minus B. So, ano yung makikita mo sa A? Aalisin mo lang yung elements o members ni B na nandoon din kay A. Okay po. So, halimbawa, set A has an elements of 1, 2, 3, and 4. Set B has an elements of 2, 4, and 6. So, A minus B is 1 and 3. Bakit 1 and 3? So, aalisin mo lang yung elements sa set A na nandoon din kay set B. So, ano ang mga elements na nandoon kay set A na mayroon din sa set B? 2 and 4. So, ang matitira mo lang ay 1 and 3. So, that is A minus B. Paano naman pag B minus A? So, pag B minus A naman, titignan mo naman yung mga elements ni B na mayroon si A. Okay? So, in this case, mayroon tayong 2, mayroon din 2 sa A. So, aalisin mo yon, tatanggalin natin. Mayroon ding 4 dito sa B, mayroon ding 4 si A. So, tatanggalin din natin. Mayroon 6 si B, pero walang 6 si A. So, therefore, your B minus A is has an element of 6. So, example number 2. Set A has an elements of A, B, C, D, and E. Set B has an elements of A, E, F, and G. So, para mas klaro sa atin, ito po yung kanyang Venn diagram. So, set A, A, B, C, D, E. Set B, A, E, F, G. So, bakit nandito sa gitna o intersection yung A and E? Kasi makikita mo yung parehas kay A, kay set A at set B. Mayroon parehas may A, parehas may E. So, ano nga sagot natin sa A minus B? So, titingnan natin yung elements ni set A, which are A, B, C, D, and E. Tatanggalin natin yung mga elements na makikita kay B. So, ano ang mga elements na yon? A and E. So, pag tinanggal natin to sa element sa set A, ang matitira na lang ay B, C, and D. Ito na yon. So, B minus A naman, ito naman yung titingnan natin. Ang mga elements nito ay A, E, F, and G. Tatanggalin naman natin dito ang mga elements na mayroon ding element si set A. So, tatanggalin natin yung set element A, element B. So, matitira na lang natin sa set B ay F, and G. Ito na po yun. Okay po? Okay. Let's proceed to the next topic, the cardinality. Ang cardinality, ito yung number of members of set S of, or a given set. So, halimbawa, set A has an element of 1, 2, 3, 4. So, ano ang cardinality number of set A? 4. Bakit 4? Yan o, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 na members. Set B, ilang elements niya? Or cardinality of set B? 3. So, blue, white, and red. What is the cardinality of set C? So, 5. So, bilangin natin. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, bakit naging 5? Kasi po yung A, dalawang beses na nag-appear. Pero ang bilang lang yan, kay parehas lang naman yan, A, ay isa lamang po. So, bali, bibilangin lang natin siya as 1. Kahit na limang A yan, ang bilang lang yan ay 1. Kasi para parehas lang ang elements na yan. Okay? So, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So, the cardinality of set C is 5. How about the D? So, kung susuriin natin, ang D ay empty or walang laman. So, cardinality number of D is 0. So, how about set E? What is the cardinality of set E? So, 1, 2, 3, 4, and ellipsis. Alam natin na pag itong symbol natin, ibig sabihin 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 hanggang kung saan kaya mo na. So, ang ibig sabihin nito, not defined. So, hindi siya finite set. Okay po? So, let's proceed to the next topic, the Cartesian product. Let A and B be sets. The Cartesian product of A and B denoted by A times B or AXB is the set of all ordered pairs AB, where A is an element of A and B is an element of B. Okay? So, hence, the Cartesian product of A and B is the set of ordered pairs of A and B, where A is an element of A intersection with B elements of B, set B. So, examples. Let A represent the set of all students at a university, and B represent the set of all courses offered at the university. What is the Cartesian product of A and B? Okay, so, kumbaga, A, the Cartesian product of A and B is equal to A, or ordered pair of A and B. If A, this is the set of all students, and B, the courses offered in that particular university. Okay, example number 2. What is the Cartesian product of set A as an element of 1 and 2 and B as an element of A, B, and C? So, para mas klarado, pag-iwalayin natin yung set A and set B. Okay, yung set A may elements na 1 and 2, yung set B may elements na A, B, and C. So, itong set A, yung first element niya na 1, ipipair natin sa bawat element ni set B. Okay? So, the first pair is 1A, the second pair is 1B, the third pair is 1C. Ganun din ang gagawin natin sa second pair. 2A, 2B, and 2C. So, ang final answer ng Cartesian product of A and B is 1A, 1B, 1C, 2A, 2B, and 2C. Okay? Another example, what is the Cartesian product of B is as an set B has an elements of A, B, and C, and set A has an elements of 1 and 2. So, Kung babalikan natin yung example number 2, yung first element ni set B ay ipipair natin sa bawat elements ni set A. Kasi nauna si B. Okay? B, Cartesian product of set B and set A. So, A1, ito yun. A2, ito yun. Okay? Next pair, second element ni B. Si B, sa lahat ng elements ni A. So, first element A is 1. So, B1, B2. So, next pairings is the third element of B to every element of set A. So, C1 and C2. Okay po? Ayan. So, what is the Cartesian product of set A with elements of 0 and 1, set B with elements of 1 and 2, and set C with elements of 1, 2, and 3. Okay? So, first pair, yung first element ni A. I-prepare natin sa first element ni B, sa first element ni C. Ganun po yun. So, bali 0, 1, 1. Ito yun. 0, 1, 1. Then, 0, 1. Next element sa C, 2. So, 0, 1, 2. Next is 0, 1, 3. 0, 1, 3. Okay? Next one. After that is, i-prepare natin yung first element ni A sa second element ni B. Then, to every element of C. So, 0, 2, 1. 0, 2, 1. Then, 0, 2, 2. 0, 2, 2. 0, 2, 3. 0, 2, 3. Okay? Next pair, na-pair na natin lahat yung first element ni A. Ipipair natin yung second element ni A sa first element ni B at sa lahat ng elements sa first, second, third elements ni C. So, 1, 1, 1. So, 1, 1, 1. 1, 1, 2. 1, 1, 2. 1, 1, 3. 1, 1, 3. Then, after we paired the second element of A to the first element of B, i-prepare natin yung second element ni A kay sa second element ni B. So, 1, 2, then to every element of C. 1, 2, 1. So, 1, 2, 1. 1, 2, 2. 1, 1, 2, 2. Then, finally, 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Okay? Yan po yung Cartesian products ng 3 given sets. So, key points on Cartesian product. The Cartesian products on empty set. If either of the two sets is empty, the Cartesian of these sets is also empty. Yeah. Set A has an element of 0 and 1. Pero CB is empty. So, A, the Cartesian product of A and B is empty. Or the Cartesian product of B and A is also empty. So, non-commutative property. For two unique and non-empty sets, A and B, the Cartesian product of A and B is not equal to the Cartesian product of B and A. So, hindi daw po siya equal. So, tingnan natin. So, if A is has an element of A and B has an element of 1, 2, 3, so, then, A, the Cartesian product of A and B is A1 has an element of A1, A2, A3, B1, B2, and B3. So, pairs naman ni Cartesian product of B and A. So, bali, yung B naman is 1A, 1B. Then, 2A, 2B. 3A, 3B. Yan. Okay? So, konsiderin nyo na mabuti, magkaiba po yung dalawa. Okay po? Third key points, condition for commutative property. For two sets A and B, the Cartesian product of two sets A and B and A are equal if either of the following condition is satisfied. First, either of two sets is empty. Second, both sets are equal. So, if either of the two sets is empty, if A is has an element of 1 and 2 and B has an element of, or empty, B is empty, then the Cartesian product of A and B is also empty. Or, the Cartesian product of B and A is also empty. So, hence, A times B is equal to B times A. Or, Cartesian product of A and B is equal to the Cartesian product of B and A. Okay, for the second one, both sets are equal. So, Ang given natin ay set A may merong elements na 1 and 2 at saka yung set B may elements na 1 and 2. So the Cartesian product of A and B and the Cartesian product of B and A, kung susuriin natin, parehas po siya sagot. Okay? Parehas lang. So 1 and 1, 1 and 2, 2 and 1, 2 and 2. Yung B and A naman, 1 and 1, 1 and 2, 2 and 1, 2 and 2. So parehas lang po siya. Diba ba? Yung A times A or A squared, yan lang. Parehas din. 1 and 1, 1 and 2, 2 and 1, 2 and 2. Ganun din yung B, squared. So, 1 and 1, 1 and 2, 2 and 1, 2 and 2. So, therefore, A, the Cartesian product of A and B is equal to the Cartesian product of B and A. It also equals to the A squared and B squared. Okay po. So, let's proceed to the next one. Ito po yung medyo madali lang maintindihan. So, pag sinabi natin disjoint set, wala kang makikitang magkaparehas na elements sa given sets. Okay? So, ang kanilang intersection ay empty o wala. Okay? Ito po yung Venn diagram ng disjoint set. Sa set A, hindi walang common element with set B. So, examples. Set A has an elements of 1, 2, 3, 4. Set B has an elements of A, B, C. Okay? So, anong kanyang intersection? Wala. Or empty. Okay? Another example. Set A has an elements of A, B, C. Set B has an elements of X, Y, Z. So, anong intersection yan? Wala rin. Okay? Wala rin. So, these are examples of disjoint set. So, finally, let's proceed to our last topic. The equal and equivalent sets. So, pag sinabi natin equal set, or the two sets are equal, only if each element in set A is also the element of set B. Okay. Pag sinabi naman natin equivalent, there are same number of elements. So, ibig sabihin yung cardinality of set A ay kaparehas ng cardinality of set B. Okay? So, all sets are equivalent but not all equivalent are equal. Yan po ang pakatandaan. Lahat daw ng equal sets are equivalent. Pero hindi lahat ng equivalent are equal. So, let's have an example. So, the following pair of sets are example of equal set. Yan. Set A has an elements of 1, 2, and 3. Set B has an elements of 3, 1, and 2. So, ibig sabihin niyan, kahit saan mo yan ilagay, magpalitan man siya ng pwesto, parehas pa rin makikita, parehas pa rin yung kanyang mga elements. So, elements ni set A, may 1 din. May 2 si set A, may 2 rin si set B, may 3 si set B. Set A, may 3 din si set B. Yan, equal siya. Ito naman. So, tingnan natin, 4 yung elements sa set A, 3 lang kay set B. Pero bakit equal set siya? Kasi po, yung 2, 2 beses na nag-appear. So, sabi ko nga kanina na kahit marami pa siyang 2s dyan, counted lang yan as 1. So, bali, ang elements mo lang sa set A ay 1, 2, and 3. So, set B meron siyang elements na 2, 1, and 3. So, they are equal. Okay. Parehas din po nito na third example natin. Dalawa yung 1. 1, 1, 2, 3. So, kumbaga, ang elements lang na set A ay talagang 1, 2, 3. So, set B, 4 din. Pero dalawa yung 3. O, 3, 1, 2, 3. Okay? So, counted as 1 lang yung 3. Yung dalawang 3s. Okay? So, they are equal. So, the following pair of sets are example of equivalent set. Okay po. So, number 1, set A has an elements of 1, 2, 3. Set B has an elements of A, X, Z. A, X, and Z. So, 3 elements ni A, 3 rin ang elements ni B. So, bibilangin mo lang yung elements niya. So, they are, set A and set B are equivalent sets. Okay. Number 2, A, B, B, C. Ilang elements lang nandiyan? Tatlo lang po. A, B, and C. Set B. Blue, blue, white, red, red, red. Ang dami kung titingnan natin. Pero actually, kung susuriin natin, tatlo lang ang elements na nandiyan. Blue, white, and red. So, therefore, pair number 2, yung set A and set B are equivalent sets. Okay, number 3. Set A is the set of all X such that X is the number of Olympic rings or number of Olympic rings. So, ilan ang Olympic rings natin? 5. 5 yon. So, set B is the set of all X such that X is a positive integer and X squared is less than 36. Okay. So, tingnan natin kung equivalent set siya. Ilan ang Olympic rings? 5. Okay, 5 po yan. So, ilan naman ang integers na ang X squared dapat less than daw siya sa 36. So, positive integers. Squared of 1 is 1. Squared of 2 is 4. Squared of 3 is 9. Square of 4 is 16. Square of 5 is 25. So, square of 6, ang susunod na integer, 36. So, magiging false na to. So, ilan lang ang integers na ang square niya is less than 36. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So, parehas po mayroong 5 elements ang set A at set B. So, therefore, this pair of sets are equivalent sets. Okay na po, naintindihan na. Maraming salamat po sa inyong panonood. Sana po mayroon po kayong natutunan kahit paano. Muli, ako po si Teacher Narsing. Goodbye at salamat po sa inyo.